Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to tell you the knowledge about the primitive data types. So when we talk about the primitive data types, we have to consider some data types as follows. We have the number type and the string type. Also, we have to take care of the operations of the two different data types called number and string. I'm also going to talk about the Boolean type a little bit. I'm also going to talk about the null type, and finally, I'm going to talk about the typeof keyword that helps me show the data type of a variable. Now, let us see the HTML file first. So the HTML file is a very simple one. I just contain the title of the web page together with a simple heading, and I just want to include my script in the body of the HTML file. So the script is called myscript.js, and it is placed inside the JS folder. And the JS folder is at the same level of the HTML file. Okay, so let me go to the myscript.js file. I have to use the strict mode, so I say use strict at the very beginning of the HTML file. So the first thing to talk about is the number type. The number is quite easy. I can set up a number of variables that include number as the value. Now, the variable is called number1 and it has a value of 3.4. And then I set up two more variables called number2 and number3. Number 2 has a value of 7, and number 3 has a value of 2, okay. This is the way of setting up numbers in the variable. And the next thing to discuss is the string data type. Okay, I have two variables called string1 and string2. So string1 has a value of hello, and the string2 has a value of world. So when I want to set up a string, we have to include a pair of double quotation marks or a pair of single quotation marks. So these two quotation mark pairs are allowed. And we have to talk about the operation of the number type and the string type now. So I start with the number type first. So I want to add up the two numbers and I want to show the result in the alert window. So let me save it and reload the page. I will get 10.4 because I just add up 3.4 and 7, which becomes the result shown in the alert window. Save and reload. I will get minus 3.6 because I'm just doing the subtraction of the two numbers. 3.4 minus 7 gives me minus 3.6, so that is the result. I can also do multiplication. So I use an asterisk to represent the multiplication of two numbers. Save, reload. 23.8 because it comes from the product of 3.4 and 7. Okay. When I want to do division, I can use a forward slash to represent the division operation. So 3.4 divided by 7 would give me something. Save, reload. It gives me 0.4857 something. So this is the answer of a certain division indicated by the division of 3.4 by 7. Okay. How about dividing a number by 0? Let me see. if I want to divide number 1 by 0, what will happen? Save, reload the page. I will have infinity, because a non-zero number divided by 0 would give me infinity. Okay, in addition to the ordinary operation of numbers, I can also find out the modulus of two numbers, that is the remainder of the two numbers when I do the division. When I want to do number 2 divided by number 3, I can simply get the remainder by using a percentage sign. Okay, number 2 divided by number 3 gives me 3 as the quotient and 1 as the remainder, so we expect that the result will be equal to 1. Save, reload. Okay, 1 is given out. So the remainder of 7 divided by 2 gives me 1. So how about multiplying a string with a number? Can we really do so in JavaScript? Let us see. Suppose I want to do the multiplication of hello by 2, which is not really sensible as able to be performed in JavaScript. Let me see. Save, reload. So you have a value coming out as NaN, which is called not a number. So what does it mean by not a number? It just says that we cannot do the multiplication of a string with a number. The result will not be a number. Okay, let me go to the string operation. We can use a backtick to help me pack some variables into a string. Okay, when I want to join two strings together with the separation by using a space, I can do something like this. I include the backtick at the very beginning and at the very end, and then I use a dollar sign together with a pair of curly brackets to include the variable, which is in the form of a string. And same for another string. So string 1 is hello and string 2 is world. By including the space in between the two variables, I'm going to show the hello world statement. So let me save it. Save, reload. You'll see hello world is given out. The space here between the two words is simply indicated by the space shown in the middle of the alert statement, okay? So I can show you one more example of the string operation. Okay, I can also include some more words in the string. The string 1 value is simply hello. And after hello, I want to pack more words into a sentence. So let me save it and reload the page. Okay, you see that the variable content is shown at the very beginning of the sentence because this is the position that I put the variable, okay? The other part is called the Boolean values. A Boolean variable can have only two values, one is true and one is false. So now let me set up some variables of Boolean type. Okay, if sunny is set as true, while is happy is set as false. So the value of true and false are simply typed in all small letters. So when I do the printing by means of the alert window, we can have the effect as follows. Save it and reload the page. So the first one is simply true because I'm printing the content of a sunny variable. The second one is false because I simply print out the value of is happy. Okay. In assigning a Boolean value to a variable, we don't always need to say true or false only. we can have some operation that determines the truth value, and then we assign the truth value coming from the expression into the variable. Okay, the variable called is smaller is simply obtained from the truth value coming from this expression. So 3 is smaller than 6, so we will expect that this comparison gives me a true value. So the result will be shown in the alert window. So let me try now. Save, reload. See, we have true as the answer because 3 is really smaller than 6. So the Boolean value representing this comparison is true, and I print out the true value as the smaller variable content. Another data type issue is known as null. We can set up a variable to be null. So what does it mean by this one? Let me see. Now I say that the salary variable has a value called null. So what would happen when I simply want to print out the value in the alert window? Save, reload. I will say null here. So the meaning of null here simply means nothing. So in this case, we simply have a value called null to be put into the salary variable. And null here means nothing. So I didn't really put a certain number into a variable. I just say that I put null, or I put nothing to the variable. And then I'm going to show the primitive data type by using the keyword called typeof. I can print out the data type of number 1, which is simply 3.4. So we will expect that it is a number. So let me see the result by saving it first. And then reloading the web page. You see it is a number. So type of keyword helps me to find out the data type of a certain variable. So now it is number. So for string 1, it is shown that it has a value of a string. So this one called hello. So we will expect that the type of string 1 is simply a string. Save, reload. Yes, the answer is string. So how about the Boolean type? Let me see how to show the data type. I say typeof is certainly. It certainly is simply true, which is a Boolean value. So when I save it and reload the page, I will see Boolean as the answer coming from the alert window. How about another variable called salary? Salary is set as null. So what would happen when I print out the data type of this variable? Save, reload. You see, it is called an object. So what does it mean by this one? Object type is simply an incorrect representation of the null value, because null is simply a value of the primitive data type. It doesn't really represent a type itself. It just tells me the value of a certain variable, which is called null. So this one is not really sensible when I say that null is of object type. And one more example is the data type of an alert window. We already know that an alert window is a built-in function for us to show some strings or some numbers in the window. So what would happen when I simply want to test the type of the alert window? Save and reload. Oh, we see that it is of a function type. So the function type here means that alert is simply a function that is provided by JavaScript. and it is not regarded as one of the variable types shown above, okay? So this video has already talked about so many details about the primitive data types. We can set up the numbers, strings, and we can also set up some operations to calculate some values between two numbers. We can also set up some string operations by using the backticks at the beginning and at the end of your string content. We also see the ways to assign Boolean values by using true or false and by using the Boolean expression directly. We also see that a variable can be set as null, which means nothing. And we are also able to print out the data type of a certain variable by using a typeof keyword. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.